Dear students, now we can discuss the problem number 18. A ball is thrown up vertically and returns to the thrower after 6 seconds. So he throw the ball and it will return to the thrower at 6 seconds. So what is the time taken for ascent? It will be 3 seconds and for descent will be 3 seconds. So the time taken for ascent and descent will be equal. That is, a ball taking a time to moving upwards is equal to the moving downwards. So find the velocity with which the ball is thrown up. What is the maximum height? And what is the position of the ball at 4 seconds? We know that the total time taken is 6 seconds. So the time of ascent is equal to time of descent. So the time taken to reach the maximum height is 3 seconds. So at maximum height, the final velocity is 0. The acceleration due to gravity is negative because the ball is start to come down. So it is moving upwards. So the negative value. Then time taken is 3 seconds. So the ball is thrown vertically upwards. It will move upwards. It takes a time 3 seconds to reach the maximum height. So this is the maximum height. So what is the time taken for reaching this height? 3 seconds. What is the final velocity in this point? It is 0. The gravity is negative as the body is moving upwards. So V is equal to U plus GT. So U, the G is acceleration due to gravity is minus. So we can put minus. Substituting U comes to this side and the velocity, final velocity comes to the right side. So we get an answer. The initial velocity is 29.4 meter per second. Then the next question is, subdivision B is maximum height reaches. What is the maximum height? So at the maximum height, the final velocity is 0. The gravity is minus 9.8 meter per second square. By substituting these values in, V square is equal to U square plus 2GH. H is equal to V square minus U square by 2G. Often we are using this equation. Keep in your mind. So final velocity is 0 square minus 29.4 the whole square by 2 into minus 9.8. By solving this equation, we found that the maximum height reached is 44.1 meter. That is, the maximum height reached is 44.1 meter. Then the next question is, what is the time taken? What is the position of the body at 4 seconds? So the time taken for maximum reach is 3 seconds. So time taken for maximum height is 3 seconds. So after that it will come 1 second down. So we have to find what is this position. So we can calculate this distance or this distance. So at this point the velocity is 0. The maximum height we know that. And the time is 1 second. So we can take in that S is equal to UT plus half GT squared. So S is as it is. The initial velocity, the velocity is 0 because it comes to the rest, then only it will fall freely due to the acceleration due to gravity. Then half, then G is a positive, as it is comes down it is a positive, and time taken is 1 second. By substituting this we get an answer 4.9 meter. That is, this distance is 4.9 meter. So what is this distance? The total distance is 44.1. So 44.1 minus 4.9 is 39.2 meter. So that is a 39.2 meter is a, from the ground that is a distance covered by this body at 4 second, or from the top of the height it will be 4.9 meter. So this type of questions will be repeatedly asked in any board exams or the final exams. So any competitive exam for the NTSC also, they are asking this type of questions. So prepare these questions and practice on your own. Dear students, so some of the portions are deleted by the CBSE. So that is after buoyancy, the buoyancy pressure and all, the topics and all deleted in this gravitation unit. So the remaining questions, exercise questions 19, 20, 21, 22 are not discussed in this exercise part. Similarly, these are all the pages are deleted portions. That means I will show to you from the pressure up to this we are completed. So from this onwards there is a no in this index question also discussed. Solution is sent in the last week itself. From this thrust, pressure and these parts and all deleted portions. So if you have any doubt, you can go through our syllabus. If possible, I will send the syllabus copy in our Google Classroom. You can go through it. Okay, revised syllabus copy. So we are completed the lesson number 10. What is the topic of this lesson 10? The lesson 10, gravitation theory, question and answers, book exercise, discussions, everything over. Today I will send the solution for exercise questions, question number 1 to question number 18. You have to write the question and answer in your classwork note. It is compulsory for all. So you have to write today's work is, you have to watch these videos and complete the exercise up to question number 18 in your classwork note. I will send the solution for these questions in the Google Classroom itself. You can see the question and answer and copy it. Okay. Thank you, students.